Hello students, now we are going to discuss the eightfold symmetry of the mesons and the baryons. So Gell-Mann in 1961 had proposed the eight-way symmetry in the mesons and baryons. He had predicted that all the eight particles in the mesons as well as in the baryons, they represent, they are the type of the same kind and they are the different states of the same entity. Means just the states are different but the particles are same. So Gell-Mann had given this eightfold symmetry. What is in this eightfold symmetry? He had already proposed that, and we also know that all the baryons are fermions. So fermions are the particles which have the spin, which is the half integral of h cross by 2 pi, or the spin quantum number is half. Whereas the mesons are the particles which may be considered as the bosons, that they obey the Bose-Einstein characteristics and they have integral spins or have the spin zero. So here we have represented on the graph. On the x-axis, we have the isotopic spin, the radial component of the isotopic spin, that is isospin, Iz. And on the y-axis, we are representing the hypercharge. So, Iz is the isospin, the z component of the isospin, and y is the hypercharge. So, we have already calculated the R component of the isospin and the hypercharge quantum numbers. So this is the baryon family. We have considered the particles, not the antiparticles. Similarly, the way we are representing the particles, we can also represent the antiparticles also. So in this, we have the eight particles, that is sigma naught, lambda naught, neutron, proton, and the three sigmas, that is sigma plus, sigma minus and sigma naught. And we have the cascades, that is cascade neutral and cascade negative. So when we plot on the IZY graph, what we see that sigma naught and the lambda naught have the IZ and Y value 0. So this is the point where this is coming on the graph. Whereas sigma plus and sigma minus are having the hypercharge value 0. But sigma plus has IZ value plus 1 and IZ value minus 1 for sigma negative. Proton and neutron both have IZ value half, but the hypercharge value is plus 1 because they are non-strange numbers, they are having the baryon number, so hypercharge value is plus 1. And the cascades neutral and cascade negative are having the baryon number minus 1 because the strangeness number was minus 2. Adding the baryon number plus 1, it gives the hypercharge value minus 1. So cascade neutral and cascade negative have the hypercharge negative, but the IZ value is plus half for cascade neutral and it is minus half for cascade negative. So this is the representation in which the eight particles can be represented in this symmetry curve. Here is the meson family. The same way we have depicted the baryons, we can depict the mesons also. So here again on the x-axis we have the IZ and on the y-axis we have the hypercharge. So we have the three particles, pi positive, pi naught and pi negative. They are not baryons, they are not the strange particles. So IZ value is 0 and obviously the hypercharge value is also 0. So pi naught and eta naught are at the zero value of the hypercharge and IZ. Pi positive is at plus 1 value of IZ where it is not having any hypercharge value. Similar is the case for pi negative, where pi negative is also at a negative IZ value minus 1 and hypercharge value is 0. Eta naught is again 0 at the IZ and Y value. Since the kaons or the K particles are at the are the strange particles, but the baryon number is 0. So whatever is the strangeness number, that is the same as the hypercharge value. So the K particles have a IZ value of half. So it is having plus minus half values for the various K positive and K naught bar are having plus IZ values. and k naught and k minus k negative has a iz value of negative half, but the y have a they have a value of 1 because the strangeness is 1. So the strangeness is 1 for k positive and k naught. So k lies in the first quadrant, k positive, and k naught lies in the second quadrant, whereas the k negative lies in the third quadrant because iz is negative, that is minus half, and obviously y is also negative half, negative minus 1. So k minus is supposed to lie here in the third quadrant, and k naught bar is having a value of iz plus half and y value of minus 1. So this is the placement of the k naught bar in the fourth quadrant. So you can see here that there are the 8 particles that are composed in the four quadrants, and similarly here also there are 8 baryons that are composed in this four quadrants, and the symmetry is exactly the same. So this is why this is called the eightfold symmetry, and we can say that all the 8 particles are similar to each other. They are of the same kind, they are of the same entity, but the states are different. They are having different states, but the kind or the entity are same. So that is why it is called the eightfold symmetry. And we could also represent the space as invariant space. When we do the transformations, then the transformations come out to be invariant. So this was the Gell-Mann's eightfold way symmetry proposed by him, and I hope that you have understood. Thank you.